Welcome to AXPONA 2014 on enjoythemusic.tv. I'm your host, Stephen R. Rochlin. We're here with Sean and Chuck of Zoo Audio. Let's give a round of applause. Woo! Now, we've got three people on camera. I decided to totally obliterate the virtual studio, and it's like small, medium, large. This one's too small. This one's just right. That one's hot. So, gentlemen, Zoo Audio, hot product, great stuff. Your speakers have won countless awards.
We're not counting.
Yeah, okay. One, two. No, they really have won a lot of awards. Their speakers are awesome, and they're not like $50,000 or $250,000 speakers. You know, they start at how much?
Yeah, $1,000.
$1,000 for a pair of speakers.
That are made in the States.
That are made here in the United States of America.
Mostly Chuck's. No.
Yeah. Mostly Chuck?
No.
So that's why he's the silent partner.
Yeah, I only talk when Sean gives me permission.
Yeah, actually, the mic's working. It's working,
good,
so this
right
is
on.
A good deal.
Nice.
Cool. So, gentlemen, let me go ahead and pull up your website.
Yeah, please.
And let's go ahead now. Look at this cool, cool cabinet. Tell people a bit about it.
Yeah, so this Credenza is a console unit. It's a full-feature loudspeaker system. It's got our full-range coax on either side, and then a built-in subwoofer system in the bottom, and the console is designed to be able to support a loudspeaker or a turntable on the top. To keep it from coupling, we've got maglev between the two, so you can have a pretty nice size party and not have to worry about your needle skating across your vinyl. Chuck is the architect, I'm the engineer.
So he's the DJ and you're the, oh, I forget what they call it, rapper, that's it.
Oh, yeah, God. MC.
I'm having a brain fart.
Yeah, you can do that.
So there was another product that you said you wanted to talk about as well, which was the Druid, I believe, correct?
Yeah. So we launched our company back in 2000, originally funding what we wanted to do with some loudspeaker or the cable products, and we rolled in those funds into the Druid. It's been with us now for about 14 years here at the show, showing that off. Really happy with it. It's high efficiency, high power handling, 16 ohm. You can hook a lot of different amplifiers up to it. It sounds really fantastic, easy to work with, looks good, designed to last 100 years.
Uh-oh, now you're not throwing the cake at me, I hope.
Those leftovers, we gotta.
Oh, you brought me leftovers.
It was just too much last night, so we have.
Now, I see your speakers come in a variety of colors, like those black.
Anything you want. Anything, literally. So we're very vertically integrated. So we not only make our own drivers, we do our own cabinetry, cable assemblies. We also do the finish work. So really, if you want automotive, high gloss, cut, polish, beautiful, fancy, you know, Maserati, Luna Tuno, or if you want, Mango Tango from Dodge, yeah, we're here to make it happen. We also do the wood finishes too. But.
Cool. Now these guys just broke out some cake. So part of me is fearing that.
This is normal cake, man. This is not. This is just. This is leftovers.
Wait. Oh, you mean you're not from Denver?
No, we're not.
Colorado
yeah.
cake is.
No, this is Chicago
Look
cake.
Look how big that thing is.
That was one slice.
That's what she
from
said.
Last night. Yeah. And they said, yeah, just but it's you know.
So
they came and brought cake.
Yeah, just because you know it's lunchtime.
Well, you know, this is the Zoo Audio guys. They are that cool. We're just gonna relax. We're gonna eat. Mm.
We didn't have time for breakfast, and so we thought cake.
Hey, that's a breakfast lunch. Of champions. So what else did you want to tell people about Zoo Audio and your speakers?
They're different. Yeah, if you guys are looking for something that is off the beaten path a little bit, more reminiscent of something you might have grown up with, but with modern sensibilities as far as material sciences, ability to play trance, crazy music, as well as be extremely dynamic and innovative in the sound presentation, in that it doesn't always just sound big and spacious. Sometimes you're listening to, you know, music that's nice and tight and should be intimate. Magnolia
Electric
Company,
that kind of
thing.
Now we're looking at what looks like machine panels.
Yeah, so these are the bases you're looking at. Those are fitted onto the bottom of the speaker. It's a cosmetic part, but it also helps to, you know, control some of the resonance of the cabinet, so the cabinet isn't as noisy as it would have been without it. And yeah, so a lot of the machine work that's done right next door. We do all the CAD, all the all the design work is in-house, all assembly. There's some finished shots.
A paint shop.
The paint, yep. So we've got two different paint booths, depending on what we're doing. One's a clean room. The other one is kind of a dirty booth. But, yeah, like I said, we like to keep our hands dirty.
Now, what makes your drivers so special? Because, obviously, that's incredibly important, too.
Yeah, so the full-range driver that we do is unique in the full-range driver world. It's a 10-inch driver. The reason it's 10-inch drivers, it's about the same size as your head. And that was a design premise that Harry Olson did back in the 30s. You know, famous guy, basically the godfather of all modern dynamic speakers. But it's about the same size as your head. It's centered in the human voice, not in the treble region. It plays very full range, but it does need a little bit of burnish added to it on the top end. So you've got a super tweeter on the top that comes in at the uppermost treble range, 10K. And those two elements together are very integrated and holistic sounding.
Well, they're excellent speakers.
Yeah, thanks, Steve.
And as I recall, Enjoy the Music gave you an award for them, as I recall.
Yeah. We did. Got an award last year from you. I think it was on the Union, which is a model just down from this.
Yep.
And we were really happy to get that. Nice to get some recognition.
Well, you know, you guys are doing great.
Thank you.
There's no doubt about it. Anything else you'd like to tell everyone before we kind of scooch on off?
Chuck, you haven't been talking much. You want to talk about that console? A lot of people want to hear about the console.
Yeah.
Sure. I debated on whether to talk about the cake or the console, but we'll go with the console. Very inspired mid-century. Sean and I are both big fans of mid-century furniture. And so Charles and Ray Eames, Dieter Rams, you can see a little bit of the brawn pattern in the grills there. And the different colored doors, we got inspiration from Arne Vauder and Finn Jewell. But the fact that when Sean threw out the idea of the top part levitating, my mind exploded.
Yeah, I just had to, you know.
And so when people come in our room here at AXPONA and we tell them you can push on that top part because it's actually floating in midair, they don't believe us. But last night we played a cut from James Blake. And the bass, we put it to the test, basically. And
it was hitting.
The room, and the needle stayed in line. So we're excited about it. It'll be available in a few weeks on our website. And, we hope to expand the Zoo Modern line to really, you know, mix the idea of furniture with audio. Because why not?
Well, sweet. Well, thank you so much.
Thanks, Steve.
Anything else? We're gonna enjoy some cake. They should give another beauty shot. Take a look at the cake, everyone. Look at the food
Look at that thing.
Oh,
one slice.
Man, I love it. Well, everyone, as I always say, in the end, what really matters is that you enjoy the music. So let's go ahead and bring it on out. Thanks, Sean and Chuck.
Yeah, thank you.